Okay. Now, the term which is occurring in both the premises, but it is not occurring in the conclusion, is known as middle term. जो term दोनों premises में occur होता है, but it is not occurring in the conclusion, is known as middle term. So, see here, man. Man is present in both the premises, but it is not present in the conclusion. So, man is known as middle term. And the symbol of man is M. Okay, clear? Now, let us come to minor term. The subject of the conclusion. Which is the subject of the conclusion? And what is the subject? A subject is that about which something is said. So, which one is the subject of the conclusion? King is the subject of the conclusion. So, the subject of the conclusion is known as minor term. Okay? Minor term. And the symbol for minor term is S. Symbol for minor term is S. Okay? Now, the predicate of the conclusion. Which one is the predicate of the conclusion? Mortal is the predicate of the conclusion. The predicate of the conclusion is known as major term. The predicate of the conclusion is known as major term. And the symbol that represent the predicate or the major term is known as P. Okay, P. So let us write middle term. Is equal to M. Minor term is equal to S, and major term is equal to P. Okay? So these are the letters that represent middle term, minor term, and major term. Okay? Clear? Once again, what is a syllogism? A syllogism is a kind of mediate deductive inference. Okay. In a syllogism, there are only three propositions. Out of the three propositions, two are the premises and one is the conclusion. One is the conclusion. Okay. In a syllogism, there are three terms. Okay. Which are the terms? Middle term, major term, and minor term. The term which is present in the conclusion. The term which is present in both the premises but not in the conclusion is known as middle term. And the letter M stand for middle term. The subject of the conclusion is known as minor term. S stand for minor term. And the predicate of the conclusion is known as major term. P stand for major term. So before understanding the figure of the syllogism, you have to be very clear with the structure of the syllogism. ठीक है, I hope सबको समझ में आया होगा. मैंने पहले भी आप लोगों को structure समझाया है, आज फिर से मैंने revise किया. So I hope कि सबको अच्छी तरह से समझ में आया होगा. अगर कोई भी confusion है, then you can text me, you can call me also. I will explain you again. Okay? So in my next class, मैं आप लोगों को figure of the syllogism समझाऊंगी. That is also very, very important. Okay? So have a nice day all of you.